This video will cover how to build an interactive voice response menu, or IVR, using Node.js and Express as the web application framework. With less than 30 lines of code, your application will be able to receive inbound calls and capture user input entered via the keypad, which you'll then be able to further extend to include more complex and interactive elements. When Vonage receives a call on a number you have rented, an HTTP request is made to a URL, or rather, a specified webhook that contains all of the information needed to receive and respond to the call. This is commonly called the answer URL. All the information about the call progress is sent to a webhook URL you'll specify when creating an application. This is called the event URL. When a user presses a number on their keypad, you can collect it via dual tone multi-frequency, DTMF for short. Whenever a DTMF input is collected from the user, this is sent to a different webhook URL in your app, which you'll also have to specify. To get started, you'll need a Vonage API account. If you haven't already, be sure to check out the Vonage Dashboard Tour video linked below for a thorough overview. You'll need an IDE, I'll be using VS Code, Node.js installed on your machine, and ngrok in order to make the code on your local machine accessible to the outside world. Let's start writing this webhook server. Firstly, install the Nexmo CLI. Next, install Express in order to use it as the web application framework. You'll need to deal with JSON bodies, so install body parser as well by running npm install express body parser. In your main folder, create a new file called index.js and add a boilerplate express server using body parser that listens on port 3000. In order to receive a phone call, you need to create the answer URL, which is where Nexmo is going to make a GET request, and it expects to receive a Nexmo Call Control Object, or NCCO for short. This is essentially a JSON object with a set of predefined action objects. We'll use the talk action to greet the caller and ask them to press a digit, setting the bargin option to true so that the user can enter a digit without waiting for the spoken message to finish. Then, we'll add an input to the NCCO in order to capture the digit via DTMF. Set the max digits property to 1 and the event URL to a handler on your server to receive and handle the input. To reference the code here and that to follow, check the description box for a link to the GitHub repository for this demo. Let's now add the code to handle incoming DTMF in index.js. Nexmo makes a post request to the webhook, which will expose as an endpoint at webhooks/DTMF. When we receive the request, we will create another talk action that inspects the request object and reads back the digits that the caller pressed. Another post route needs to be created in the app to log all the call-related events coming in from Nexmo. To do this, add the following. Again, to look at what the final index.js file should resemble, check the description box for the link to the GitHub repository for this demo. Now you're all set up and ready to run the code. You can do that by entering node index.js in terminal. This will start a server and route any traffic to HTTP localhost 3000 through to your index.js file. In order to allow Nexmo to make requests to your app, you need to expose the code running on your local machine to the world. Ngrok is our tool of choice for this, and we've provided a great introduction to the tool that you can read to get up to speed if you haven't used it before. Be sure to check out the link for this in the description box. Once you have Ngrok installed, run ngrok HTTP 3000 to expose your application to the internet. You'll need to make a note of the ngrok URL that is generated, as you'll need to provide it to Nexmo in the next step. With the server running and available to the world, we now need to get a Nexmo phone number and link this code that will be running locally to it. Let's start by purchasing a number via the Nexmo CLI. As you can see, I've used the country code US. Feel free to use any country code you'd like and make a note of the number you purchase. We now need to create a Nexmo application, which is a container for all the settings required for your application. We need to specify the answer URL and the event URL so Nexmo can interact with the server we created. Let's use the Nexmo CLI to create your application. Be sure to use the generated URL that ngrok provided you earlier in this step. The response you'll get back will contain a huge private key output, and above that, an application ID. You can ignore the private key as it isn't necessary for handling inbound calls, but make a note of the application ID. Now you have an application that is connected to the server and a Nexmo phone number, but the phone number isn't connected to the application. So let's link the number you just bought to the application you created. Use the CLI to issue the following command and be sure to replace the phone number and application ID shown with your own. If you hadn't already done so, you'll be prompted to configure the CLI with your API key and secret from your Vonage dashboard before this step. And that's everything needed to associate your code with your Nexmo application and number. Congratulations, you did it! You can now test it all out by dialing the number you purchased and pressing a digit on your keypad. If you want to learn more about what is possible with inbound voice calls and how you can make them more complex by adding features such as recording audio or connecting callers to your mobile phone, you can learn more about these actions in the NCCO reference, linked below. If you have any questions, please leave a comment. We're ready to help. Until next time, thanks for watching!